Hello, my name is Ron Benham. I'm a field engineer here at Solo. And today I want to talk to you about how you can incrementally adopt a global multi-cluster architecture using the Gloo platform. Let's get started. So first, we'll start with just a single cluster. So let's say that this box represents my single cluster. And let's say I have a couple of workloads on here. These are your Kubernetes deployment services. So I'll just say A1 and then A2. And I also have some legacy applications running as VMs. So, you know, I'll write VM1. And then I also have some Lambda functions. So I'll do Lambdas. Okay, so now let's start sending traffic to my various workloads. And that's where Gloo Gateway comes in. Gloo Gateway is a full-fledged API gateway solution that runs natively in your Kubernetes cluster. So it's responsible for handling traffic that is coming into your cluster. So here's traffic that's coming in, and Gloo Gateway comes with things like an external authentication server, a rate limit server. It can also act as a GraphQL server, etc. But for the purpose of this video, we'll use Gloo Gateway to route that traffic to workloads that are running in the cluster. And they can do, you know, host-based routing, path-based routing, do all kinds of manipulations, et cetera, to get to wherever it needs to go. And then Gloo Gateway can also route to external services, such as VMs or Lambda functions. To control this Gloo Gateway, there you need a control plane and a management plane. And Gloo Gateway comes with an OTel collector to collect all your telemetry data. It comes with an agent, which is responsible for communicating with the control plane, therefore communicating with the data plane, which is Envoy, that is running as your Gloo Gateway. And then it comes with this management server. Next, let's add another cluster. Right, so again, I'll draw another box to represent my second cluster. And this cluster can have the same workloads that I have deployed on the first cluster for HA or DA purposes or DR purposes, or it could have new workloads that you might want to introduce for canary purposes. So let's just say I have A2 again replicated across both clusters, and then I have new workloads as well, which I'll represent with A3. Gloo Gateway can be used to send traffic to both the local cluster as well as remote clusters. So traffic to remote clusters would flow through Gloo Gateway and then through to A2 workloads in a separate cluster through what we call an east-west gateway. So I'll just write east-west gateway. This east-west gateway is managed by the Gloo agent. And this agent is exact same thing as this agent, and both of these agents will communicate to the management plane that is running in the first cluster. So now I can send traffic from Gloo Gateway to workloads that are duplicated across both clusters, and I can send traffic to any new workloads on the second cluster. In the future, this secondary cluster can also turn into an active primary cluster. In that case, you would deploy another Gloo Gateway. Here's Gloo Gateway again. And again, this one will come with the same exot server, rate limit server, etc. And now traffic can come to both clusters, cluster 1 and cluster 2, and route to the local clusters, as well as route to the remote services, again, by leveraging the same east-west gateway. This might be a good point to introduce mesh. With a service mesh, you have specific granular control over exactly what service can talk to what other service. So when A1 wants to talk to A2, we can make sure that this traffic is fully encrypted with MTLS. We can create the right authorization policies to make sure A1 can talk to A2. And also, now you have multi-cluster capabilities given to every one of your workloads. So meaning, if A1 wants to talk to A2, but A2 is, let's say A2 crashed or is no longer available in that server, it's not healthy, A1 can automatically talk to A2 sitting in a completely separate cluster, again, going through the east-west gateway. And this failover from one cluster to another is automatically handled using the Gloo platform. Another thing you can do is A1 can also talk to A3 in this cluster, again, going through this east-west gateway to get to it. As you start adding more clusters now, let's say you have 3, 5, 10, 100, you now are at a point where you can start thinking about moving the management plane to its own dedicated cluster, right? So let's say now you have another cluster. Think of this as an internal cluster that is dedicated to just the management plane. So we're going to move this management plane out of cluster one and run it in a separate cluster. What this gives us is gives you a central point to manage all of your service mesh, all of your north, south, and east, west traffic communication policies from a central place. So as an operator, you apply your Gloo routing policies, security policies, et cetera, to the management plane. And the management plane knows where all your workloads are, and it knows where all your gateways are, and it's able to program all of those by talking to the agent. There's also OTel collectors, like I mentioned, in every cluster. And that OTel collector can gather all the metrics, send it back to the management plane. The management plane also comes with a UI so that you can use the built-in dashboard or connect it up with your own existing observability stacks. Another next good incremental step to take from here is to have dedicated gateway tiers. So that looks like a separate dedicated cluster whose sole purpose is to act as the ingress cluster. So in this case, you would deploy Gloo Gateway in this cluster, and all of your external traffic now comes to Gloo Gateway. So I'll use this color. All traffic now comes to Gloo Gateway, and then you no longer need a Gloo Gateway per cluster. So you can get rid of these. There's no external traffic coming in, no external traffic coming in. And now Gloo Gateway can route to your destinations regardless of where they are. This means that you can now give every line of business within your organization their own Kubernetes cluster. And depending on how the traffic looks like, you know, whether you're doing path-based routing or host-based routing, can route to the right destination automatically. As workloads move from one cluster to another, because the management plane knows where those workloads are living, it can program the Gloo Gateway automatically to route to the correct destination no matter where that exists. This architecture is very scalable because you can add more and more clusters and you can add workloads to those clusters without impacting every other cluster. And you can also deploy one of these instances per region. You can leverage, because all of the components are modular, you can reuse components as necessary and only deploy the components that are required per cluster. A single management plane can control multiple clusters, multiple workload clusters, as well as multiple gateway clusters. I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me at ram@solo.io, or you can reach out to us using our contact page. Thank you.